Dear learners, happy to see you all. In the previous module, we have explored different types of looping statements such as for, while, etc. in Python. In this module, we are going to focus on three jump statements, namely break, continue, and pass statements in Python. As you all know that for loops and while loops in Python allow you to repeat a set of tasks. When this occurs, you may want your program to exit a loop completely, skip part of the loop before continuing, etc. That is, you may need to alter the flow of a loop as you want, that is to skip a part of the loop or terminate a loop, etc. Hence, Python provides three jump statements such as break, continue, and pass statements to handle such situations and to have a good control on your loop. Let us take a real life example. Suppose your mom asks you to go to market and get potato, tomato, onion, beans, and carrot. You're on the job and you bought potato and tomato. When you're looking for onion, you get a phone call from your mom saying that onion is not needed. So what will you do? You will stop buying onion and proceed to buy beans and carrot. And another example is, you want to work with information of all aged people except people aged 65. When you encounter the details of a person aged 65, you will skip processing his data and get the details of next person. This is what continue does. It comes out of the current iteration of the loop and start with next iteration. Let us restate this problem in another way. Suppose your mom asks you to go to market and get potato, tomato, onion, beans, and carrot. Now you are on the job and you bought. Suppose your mom asks you to go to market and get potato, tomato, onion, beans, and carrot. You are on the job and you bought potato and tomato. When you are looking for onion, you get a phone call from your mom saying that an important guest has come home. He wants to leave immediately for catching a train. Before leaving, he wants to meet you. What would you do now? Will you continue to buy or stop buying and leave for home? Yes, you will break the purpose of going to the market and come back home immediately. This is what the break does. It comes out of the loop and continues to execute the statements after the looping statements. Having seen a real life example, let us now see how and when to use break in Python. Python, like C, C++ and Java, provides a special purpose statement called break. This statement terminates the loop immediately and control is returned to the statement right after the body of the loop. So when do we use such break statements? For example, an infinite loop can be used in computer games. To quit the game, a break is used to terminate the infinite game loop. Another example, imagine you are searching for an element in a long array. If you find the element near the beginning of the list, there is no point to continue the search to the end of the list. In Python, break provides you with the opportunity to exit out of the loop when some condition is met. The break statement in Python terminates the current loop and resumes the execution at the next statement after the looping statement, just like the traditional break found in C, C++ and Java. The break statement can be used in both while and for loops in Python. You will put the break statement within a block of a code under your looping statements, usually after a conditional if statement. The syntax of a break statement is just give break in your script. Have a look on the flowchart that illustrates the functioning of a break statement. So here you can see the flowchart representing the working of a break. So we start with a looping statement. As you know, if the loop fails, you will come out of the loop and execute a different set of statements which is outside the loop. Suppose if the loop condition evaluates to true, we are getting inside the loop. Inside that, I have a condition. If the condition is true, we break. That is, we break out of the loop and go to the statement which is outside the loop. Suppose if the condition evaluates to false, then we don't break. We continue to execute the remaining statements in the loop and we go with next iteration and so on. See how to use break in a for loop. Here we have a for statement. We have an iterating variable which iterates over a sequence and we have some statements 1 and 2 and we have a if statement where if condition is true then we have a break. This is a typical use of break in looping statements. Let us now write an example for loop that has break in it. Consider writing a script that finds the sum of n positive numbers entered by the user. But if the input is negative, display the sum and end the script. Try the script on the console. So here we have a program that finds the sum of the n elements. But suppose in between, if we enter a negative number, then we break, come out of the loop, stop adding. So we are getting the number of elements to be added. Then for that number, we are creating a for statement. Within the for loop, we read the first number. If the number is less than 0, we break. That means we come out of the for loop, we go and print the sum. Suppose if the number is not negative, we add it to the sum and we go and repeat the process of getting the next number and so on. Check this program whether it breaks when the condition is met. Watch the output on the screen. So here I want to add 4 elements, but after entering 2 elements, third input is negative. So without getting the third and fourth input, we stop and we come out, print the numbers that have been added so far before entering the negative number. Consider another example for break in a for loop, but this time we use a list. So here we create a list called numbers whose items are 0 to 9 and we have created another integer object ELE whose value is 7. We have a for loop which has a iterating variable number NO which iterates over the list, that is the number. We are printing the number, but if the number is equal to the element, that is 7, then we break. So you try by yourself and find the output. If you execute the code, you will notice that all the numbers are printed except 8 and 9 because the loop gets terminated when 7 is found in the list. Let us see one more example that shows the behavior of break statement. Let us use an if statement inside a for loop to deduct the underscore in the given string. Welcome to Python course. And we use break statement before printing out the letters in the string and let us see what happens. So here we have a string called welcome to Python course with underscore embedded in it. So we iterate over each character present in the string using the iterating variable letter. So if the letter is underscore, we break. And if it is not underscore, we just print the letter. So what would be the output? So initially W will be the first letter which is not equal to underscore. So letter gets printed. And as and when we proceed like that, we encounter first underscore after welcome. So that letter is underscore, that is equal to underscore. So we break. We break out of the for loop and print the outside of the loop statement. So here what output you can see? You can see only welcome because we break the loop once we encounter underscore. So note that when the break is used, Python exits the for loop if a condition is satisfied. When the underscore is identified in the given string, all the other letters from underscore onwards will not be printed. Like for loops, while loops can also use break inside them. Shall we have a quick look at an example for this? So here too, you can see the use of break, but this time inside a while loop. So I have a while loop which runs forever, that is while true. We get the first number. If the number is not negative, if it is not less than 0, we add it. Otherwise, we just come out. Similar to this, we have already had a program. You just try and see what is the output you are getting. We have put the break statement within the block of code under your loop statements, usually after a conditional if statement. Can you guess why? And think yourself, what would happen if break is placed anywhere in the loop but not only under if? Now relate the real life problem which I told with the scripts what we have written now. Do you find any similarities? Have you realized the use of break? Right. Obviously, there is no difference of using break in for and while loops. It all depends on the nature of the loop, but nothing to do with break. I hope that now you are clear about the use of break in Python loops. Next, let us now turn our attention over the continue statement. The continue statement gives you the option to skip over the part of a loop when a condition is met and to go on to complete the rest of the loop. That is, current iteration of the loop will be disturbed, but the program will return to the top of the loop for next iteration. So you can always use if statements to implement the same logic, but using continue is nice for code clarity and readability. The continue statement skips all the remaining statements in the current iteration of the loop and moves the control back to the top of the loop for the next iteration. Like break, the continue statement can be used in both while and for loop. The continue statement will be within a block of code under the loop statement, usually after a conditional if statement. The syntax of a continue statement is just give continue in your script. Have a look at the flowchart that illustrates the functioning of continue statement. So here you can see the flowchart which illustrates the functioning of a continue. As we have had for break, we start with the looping statement. If the looping statement itself falls, it comes out of the loop and continue with the statement right after the looping statement. Suppose if looping statement evaluates to true, we check for a condition. If the condition is true, we continue. As you can see, we continue with the next iteration. And if the condition false, we continue with the statements after the, that is, we proceed with the statements after the continue statements and go for the next iteration. As we have written break inside for loop, we can write continue instead of break. Watch how to use continue inside a for loop. You can see how to use a continue under for loop. Especially continue is placed under the conditional statement which is similar to break. Let us write a script to find the product of 4 integer entered by the user. If the user enters 0, skip that. See the script on the console. So here we are getting the how many numbers we want to multiply, and for that many numbers we create a for loop, and we are getting the first number inside the for loop. If the number is 0, we don't multiply because multiplying with 0 will lead to 0. So if the number is 0, we continue with getting the next iteration, that is, we are getting the next number. If the number is not 0, we multiply it with product so that we will get a product. Okay, then finally we print the sum, that is the product. When you run the script, you can get the output as you are seeing. So here you can see two different runs of the previous program. When during the first run we enter three elements to be multiplied and we give the input as 2, 3, 4, so we get the output as 24. But during the second run again we try to enter three numbers, but this time we have given 0 as the input for the second number, but which didn't get multiplied. We get only 10 because first number and second number are, they have got multiplied. Consider the script which we have given for break along with list. In that script, the process of displaying the number has been stopped once the number 7 is encountered. That is, the items in the list starting from 7 onwards were omitted from being displayed. If you execute the same code using continue instead of break, what would happen? See the script and its results on the console. Here you can see we have a list with items 0 to 9 and we have an item object whose value is 7. So for we have a for loop which iterates over the numbers in the list. If the item, if the number is 7, that is equal to item, then we don't print it. So can you guess what would be the output? So this is the output you can see. You can notice 7 got omitted because of the if statement along with continue. When element in the list is equal to 7, we continue with the next iteration. The continue statement can be used to avoid deeply nested conditional code. The condition statement causes a program to skip certain steps that come up with the loop but then continue through the rest of the loop. Consider one more example for illustrating the use of continue. Observe the program on the console along with its output. We saw a similar example with break. So that time we got only the output as welcome. I hope you remember. But this time even the letter is underscore, instead of break we continue. So what does continue do? It will skip the remaining statement in the loop, continue with the next iteration. So obviously when underscore is encountered, that gets skipped, we continue with the next iteration. So that is why we are getting the output as welcome to Python course without any underscore. When the underscore was detected, Python didn't print it but continued to print the rest of the characters in the string. But recollect the output what we got for the same script when we used break instead of continue. So we have seen break and continue. What is the next jump statement? Yes, it is pass. Now let us have a glance on the pass statement in Python. When pass is used, Python ignores the condition and continues to execute the looping statement as usual. A pass statement does nothing. The only difference between a comment and a pass statement is that interpreter ignores the command but it will not ignore the pass statement. Suppose we want to create a for or while loop, but time being we don't want to give a set of statements. You can leave a pass statement in it. This is shown on the screen. Here we can see right now we need a for and while loop, but we don't have any statements to be included inside the for loop or while loop. Then we can place a pass which does nothing. The code just shown will run but has no effect. Like break and continue, the pass statement will be written in the block of code under the looping statements, typically after a conditional if statement. The pass statement in Python is used when a statement is required syntactically but you don't want any command or code to execute. The pass statement is a null operation. Nothing happens when it executes. Using the same script which we have used to illustrate the difference between break and continue, we will see the behavior of the script if we use pass in place of break or continue statement. Look at the script on the screen. The same example we had for break and continue, but this time instead of break or continue we have a pass. So when the letter is underscore we have a pass. As you know, pass does nothing, nothing will happen. So you will get the output as you are saying welcome underscore to underscore python underscore course. When the underscore is detected, Python executes a pass and ignores it and prints the underscore and continues to print the rest of the letters in the string. Just compare this output with the output you obtain when you used break and continue. Dear students, till now we saw how to use break, continue and pass statements in loops. Do you think that there can be any differences between continue and pass in a for loop in Python? Yes, they do completely different things. Pass simply does nothing, while continue goes on with next iteration, skipping the remaining statements in the loop. That is, continue skips the loop's current iteration and executes the next iteration. Pass does nothing. It is just an empty statement placeholder. Computation is unaffected, but continue gets back to the top of the loop to proceed with the next iteration. Consider it in this way. Suppose you want to have a loop which does nothing. How do you write? As Python works purely on indentation and there are no empty curly braces, we cannot create an empty block enclosed within curly braces in Python. And suppose if you want to do nothing in case a condition is true. Under these situations, there is no option other than pass. Just to see the console for this case. So here you can see, suppose we want to include do nothing statements under the loop. As Python doesn't support curly braces, you cannot have what it is written. But instead, you can write a pass statement as you are seeing now. So, continue is useful only in case of loops. So, let me summarize the usage of break, continue and pass statements. Break will exit a for or while loop when a condition is satisfied. Continue ignores the remaining part of the loop but completes the rest of the loop. And pass ignores the condition and completes the whole loop. So, to summarize, I conclude that break, continue and pass statements in Python will allow you to use for loops and while loops more effectively in your code. Thank you very much for your patient listening. I hope you enjoyed this module. Thank you.